In this video, we're going to learn a little bit about how samples behave. We need to learn a little bit about how samples behave in order to be able to take a sample and generalize back to a population. In statistical analysis, we will use a sample to try and make statements about a population, but the sample that we get won't always look exactly like the population. So we need to learn a bit about how different might it look so that we can incorporate this into our procedure for making statements about a population, which we call statistical inference. As an example, let's consider drawing samples from a normal distribution that has a mean of 150 and a standard deviation of 40. Here, we're looking at a population where we know the exact mean, standard deviation, and shape of the distribution. First, we're going to look at doing this using R and running some simulations, and then we're going to look at it using a web visualization tool. First, I'm going to have R make a plot of this normal distribution. So we can see this is the true or theoretical distribution that we're going to draw samples from. I'm going to start by taking a sample of 20 out of this population. So we're going to let R know we'd like to take a sample of size 20. Here I'm going to ask R to draw a sample from a normal distribution of size 20, and the normal has a mean of 150, a standard deviation of 40. And then I'm going to ask R to give us a histogram of these 20 observations. Now taking a look at this here, you might be tempted to say this data does not look normally distributed. But because we're in a kind of artificial simulation environment here, we know that these 20 observations came from a population that was perfectly normally distributed with a mean of 150, a standard deviation of 40. Let's also take the mean of our sample. Here we can see it came out to be 146.66. And again, we know at the population, these individuals were drawn from a population that has a true mean of 150. Let's take a look at our sample. Standard deviation came out to be 34.96. And again, we know that at the population level, these 20 individuals came from a population that has a standard deviation of 40. So this gave us a little bit of an idea of how our sample varied from the true values. Let's just take a look at doing that again. To do so, I'm just going to resubmit this code, asking R to take another sample of 20 from this population. We can see the histogram here. Again, this came from a population that is normally distributed. We can see a sample mean of 163.6, sample standard deviation of 39.7. Let's ask R to do this again. Again, looking at this histogram, while it may not look, or you may not want to say that this looks normally distributed, we know that it came from a normal distribution. Sample mean of 149, sample standard deviation of 40. Let's ask R to draw another sample of 20. Again, this data came from a normal. That one actually looks a little bit more like what we might call normal. Let's ask R for one more. Again, this data came from a normal distribution. We can think of what happens if we increase the sample size. So let's ask R to draw samples of size 50 from this population. So I've increased N up to 50, and now I'm going to ask R to draw a sample of 50 from this population, make a histogram, calculate the sample mean and sample standard deviation. Again, these 50 observations came from a normal distribution. We know that. Sample mean of 157, sample standard deviation of 43. Let's look at doing this a few more times. Grab another sample of 50, take a look at the histogram, sample mean, and sample standard deviation. Let's do that one more time. Again, this data came from a normal distribution. And one more. And so again, people might be the first time taking an intro stats course, or I guess a less trained eye, might look at a histogram like this and be tempted to say that it looks skewed to the left, or negatively skewed, where in fact we know that this data came from a normal distribution, a perfectly bell-shaped and symmetric population. So I'll leave this with you. You can take this R script and you can try playing around with different sample sizes, increase it to 100, 200, whatever you like, and see how the sample estimates change. Now let's take a quick look at the same sort of example, but using a web visualization. So using a slightly nicer looking version or different looking version of the same exercise. Here we can see we have this set up to draw samples of size 20 from a population that has a mean of 150, standard deviation of 40, and if we ask to show the population, we can see that at the population level, the distribution is perfectly bell-shaped and symmetric or normal. Okay, I'm going to hide that. Now let's ask it to draw a sample of 20 for us. And we can see, taking a look at the histogram here, while you may or may not be tempted to call this normally distributed, we know that it came from a normally distributed population. Let's take a look at doing that again. So I'm going to get another sample of 20 observations. Again, this data here came from a normally distributed population. Now you can play around with it if you want. You can try increasing the sample size, seeing how the sample estimates vary. Let's go up to a large sample. Let's take 100 and see what it looks like. Here's our sample of 100 observations. This one doesn't look too bad, but either way, we're in this kind of simulation world where we know at the population level this data is normally distributed. Let's take a look at drawing one more sample of 100. Oh, that one looks pretty good. So over the course, we're going to formalize these ideas a bit more mathematically. We're going to get a more exact understanding of how samples vary from the true or population value. In the meantime, you can play around with these for the moment to get a bit more intuitive understanding of how samples vary. You can find the R script that I've used in this video, as well as a link to this web visualization in the video description below.
Subscribe to our channel, share our videos. Stick around, guys, because we got lots more. Thanks for watching our video.